my head until now.
Is that all right?
Hey, Ward, how you doing?
Hey, Daryl. Daryl, I want you to look into this through the camera here. And then I want you to speak into this microphone.
She gonna see me through that? How's she gonna hear me?
You just speak into the microphone.
Hello? Hey, Doc.
This is Inspector Monahan. I'll be speaking for Dr. Hudson.
I'm hanging up. I ain't talking to no cop. Ward, you
Dr. Hudson just received your book. Do you know anything about it?
Oh, yeah, I surely do, but that's all I'm saying until that foxy lady gets on the horn. Put her on.
Hello, Mr. Cullum.
Doc, I've been expecting your call. Hey, from one author to another, how'd you like my book?
What do you know about the man who delivered it?
Peter Curtin. What about him?
Peter Curtin?
Oh, yeah.
Peter Curtin is the name of a serial killer from the 30s in Germany.
I'll be damned. He took that man's name. He bothering you?
He broke into my apartment to leave your book.
Kind of a hand delivery, huh?
Did you put him up to it?
Doc, this Curtin guy, he's been writing me all these letters. I figured he owed me a couple of favors. So I sent a book with him to your house. I didn't think he'd break in, though. Yeah, steer clear of that son of a gun. He's a freak. He told me he's gonna send me $500 for some of my spirit. He said that he could make me immortal if he had some of my spirit. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of embarrassing. I don't really want to say it right out in front of a lady and all.
Well, I think I know what you're referring to, so what did you do about it?
I took some of that liquid soap, put in one of them sandwich baggies with a message from Jesus, telling him to mend his ways.
How are you going to contact Curtin?
This buddy of mine got paroled a couple of days ago. I figured I'd just send a baggie with him, and Curtin was going to hook up with him.
When and where? Do you know when and where?
All depends, Doc.
Depends on what?
You see, it gets awful lonesome in here, Doc. I think about you all the time. A personal token would be nice. Let's see. Something feminine. Something lacy. Something really, something pretty. I got it. Send me some of your squirrel covers.
I beg your pardon?
I beg your pardon? Your panties. You wear them, don't you? That's what I want. Look, I want them autographed to me personally. Daryll Lee Cullum, deal?
That's a promise.
All right, my buddy's gonna meet up with Peter Curtin tonight at 10 o'clock at the Denver Meatpacking Company. Doc. How's life?
Hey, Reuben.
You okay?
How'd you like to get off Chinatown detail?
Don't worry about you.
We have a lead. I think we can get this guy. Yeah, I'll be right down.
Scared. That's why you gotta come talk to me, because Jesus kept you alive for a reason. He knew Satan was in my heart, raising my hand to kill you. And Satan, he knew I had a good 6-7 years of appeals before they dropped them cyanide tablets. And I'm just like Jesus. I got disciples too. And they ain't just dying to do whatever I ask them to do, as long as I just say the word, Doc. I'm death and life to you, Doc. Death and life.